My name is Jacob Gabry. I'm currently a doctoral candidate in the Department of Media, Culture, and Communication at New York University. And in the fall, I'll begin as an assistant professor of digital media and visual culture at Stony Brook University. My research area is media history and theory, and here at MEX, I am a junior fellow. My research project deals with the early history of computer graphics and computer visualization in the United States in the 1960s and 70s, with a concrete focus on the research site at the University of Utah in Salt Lake City. Utah is this sort of strange site in the history of computer science. It's been kind of left out and neglected in a lot of ways, but Utah in this period is one of the most sort of influential and sort of productive sites for research into computer graphics. The founders of companies like Pixar and Adobe, Silicon Graphics, WordPerfect, people who would go on to do really important research at places like Xerox and NASA, all of them were graduate students at this brief period in time from 1966 to 1979 at the University of Utah. So I'm sort of interested in uncovering this neglected history in a lot of ways and sort of telling a material history of simulated images at this research site at the University of Utah. My particular approach to the study of computer graphics is through what's often referred to as media archaeology, which is sort of a method of studying the media that looks to the failed or often obscure objects of media history, so those forgotten technologies that didn't succeed and become sort of ubiquitous in the way that others did, and which is sort of a strange way of dealing with a topic like computer graphics, because computer graphics are extremely successful and extremely ubiquitous and productive in a lot of ways. But what interests me is sort of looking to the earliest moments in the history of graphics, when the technology sort of first begins to emerge, to kind of try and sort of defamiliarize it and make it a strange sort of practice, and sort of think about how this early history comes to structure the way we use computer graphics in the contemporary moment. And using Utah as this particular site, this sort of marginalized space within the history of computing technology, I try and get at this sort of strange history, a sort of way of making contemporary images strange through this particular research site. In some ways, the project is very narrow. It's about a sort of 15-year period in the history of computer science and this sort of particular obscure research site, this particular kind of media object. But I think in a contemporary context, it's extremely relevant, just because computer graphics are really one of the most ubiquitous visual media in our visual culture today. I mean, almost every image that you see in your everyday life is in some ways mediated by or influenced by or produced using computer graphics, be it images on a screen, the touch interface of a mobile device. Even print images are often produced using computer software, and obviously special effects in popular film and video games. All of these are in some ways a form of computer graphics, and they're influenced by this history in some material way. And yet almost no work has really been done on the early history of computer graphics. And the technology has become so ubiquitous that it becomes sort of invisible. We don't notice computer graphics anymore because they're so good at what they do. They disappear. So I think it's relevant to look at this early history and sort of see the moment that it first develops, to sort of ask the question of, you know, why was it made in this way, and how is this history continuing to shape the way that we understand computer graphics and digital images today? I would say I have two highlights. The first, I think, is very personal, because while I was here, sort of thanks to the time I've had and the resources of the MEX, I've been able to finish my dissertation, which is sort of a personal accomplishment. And it was really, you know, thanks to the time and the sort of colleagues I've had here and the discussions we've had, it's been a really fantastic experience. So that would definitely be my first highlight. But I think a more academic and in some ways personal highlight would be participating in the workshop that we had on cultural analytics and information aesthetics, specifically being able to present for and talk to Frieder Nacke, who was one of the guest speakers and who is a hugely important figure in the history of computer graphics in the 1960s, in the German context. And a lot of what I wanted to do here was to start to think about the history of computer graphics in Germany and the history of computer graphics in the United States sort of at the same time together. So being able to present my work to him and talk to him afterwards about my project was really a fantastic experience, and I think it was really the highlight of my time here.